Do you think that if the U.S. endorsement wasn't as strong, if he didn't have that, do you think that he would feel this sense of invincibility that he can do whatever he wants to?
I think that he relies too much on his economical sort of influence on the oil market. Because right now, one thing that is like one of the main things that is holding the dollar as the currency that has been used to trade in oil is that it's pegged to most of the Gulf currencies. It's pegged to the dollar, it's pegged to the Saudi riyal, the Emirati dirham to a certain degree, I think 90% is pegged to the dollar, right. The Bahraini dinar, and Saudi has a lot of influence here. Imagine if we change that instead of pegging our currency to the dollar, to the euro. The dollar would not recover after that. I think he's relying too much on that. I think the dollar would recover just fine within a decade because, yeah, trading in oil is not going to last for long. The Americans still have a lot of businesses in the Middle East. They have a lot of bases in here. They do make a lot of money out of the Gulf region. So just kicking out all the Americans that are living here, just being paid by being just sitting around in a base doing nothing, that would hit them hard. So now, are the Americans going to recover? Yes, of course they're going to recover. They have a much stronger economy, a more diversified economy than Saudi Arabia right now. But I think MBS and his administration is relying too much on that aspect of it.
Secular Jihadists is an increasingly influential podcast with much of its growing audience in Muslim-majority countries, advocating for atheists, secularists, and Enlightenment thinkers. We want to reach out to more people. If we reach 500 patrons, we will be able to translate our shows into Arabic, Urdu, Persian, Bengali, Malay, Turkish, and other languages in these countries. Help us get there at patreon.com/SJME.